Frank, the traveler man, and...
I'm Dee Dee, his wife. I didn't think he was going to introduce me, but
he did. You know. But by the way, this is episode number 3. And first of all, everyone knows that I'm very cheap. And this whole episode is about what happens when you're cheap. Now, I went to pick up our his and her chainsaws at my chainsaw guy's place. And he said, and I was telling him, you know, we're getting ready to take a long trip to Alaska. And, you know, we're going to be carrying kayaks and the whole thing. So I got to get a rack. He says, wait a minute. I've made a lot of racks. And I'll be happy to do it for you for $175. And I'm going, this is great. Because REI was $500 on sale. And I thought, hey, I'm saving some money here. Mr. Cheap again. So anyway, this is like, I said, done. Do it. I'll be happy. You just go ahead and do it. So that's about June
18th. How long was it going to take him to make it, Frank?
10 days.
Oh, 10 days. Okay. Yeah, 10 days. From June 15th?
Right around there, yeah, for 10 days. So anyway, so what happened is I said, hey, well, great. So on July 1, I checked with him. I said, how are we doing? He says, I got the metal. I'm getting ready. Okay.
I haven't started it because I've had a bad heel.
Yeah, his heel's hurting him. Anyway, so that's okay. And I feel bad for the guy. He's a great guy. Anyway, so then on about the 5th, I go, how are we doing? Not quite there yet, but it's close. I go, okay. So the end product is, this goes on. And now, by the way, we're supposed to leave on July 19th for our trip. And my wife's saying, don't blink. Well, you know what? I've been driving all day. And by the way, it is so hot here where we are. It's 100 degrees. And Dee will explain that later. Anyway, finally, I find a guy in, we're in Sparks, Nevada, and we're having problems because the kayaks are wobbling back and forth. Now, mind you, I can just see two kayaks going right through the window of our Airstream.
I can see him going off the back end.
Yeah, there you go.
Through the, onto the freeway.
So, end product is, I find a metal fabricator guy. He says, I'll do it, and I'll do it right for you. And by the way, it'll get done. Just give me your truck tonight, and I'll have it for you by 10 a.m. tomorrow, and you'll be on your road. I'm going, this is great. So, long and short of it is, I said, I need a place to stay. He says, hey, I got a place.
A perfect place in Sparks.
And it's called the Sparks what?
Sparks Marina. But usually when you think of a marina, you think of water. Well, there was no water. What it was an RV park. You had about 30 feet. And they catered to the big motorhomes. So these are motorhomes. Most of them were over 500,000. Some were 1 million. So here we are, motorhome, motorhome, our little trailer, motorhome, motorhome, motorhome. And of course, they think we're crazy because we have no room in our, they've got 2 bedrooms, 2 baths, and a washer, dryer. They don't even need the laundry facilities at the place where we're staying.
And by the way, our trailer costs more than the current house we live in.
Yeah, yeah, it does. But theirs cost a lot more, so anyway, we're stuck in Sparks. It's hotter than heck. The guy that made all the arrangements for us and said we'd have it by 10 o'clock, he was babysitting his grandson that day. So, but we didn't know that. So when we called, they said,
It'll be done by 3 o'clock the next day. I said, that's impossible. I said, we have to be on our way. And I mean, we got to be on our way to go to?
Well, we were going to Goose Lake in Oregon, and we had to cancel that. But the thing is, I think checkout time was like 12 o'clock, and we weren't going to make a 12 o'clock checkout time. They charged us an extra day to stay in their marina. We were out of there by about 3.
$50 for an extra couple hours, but
I think we got it. I think we picked the trailer up at about 1 o'clock, but then we have to hook it up and, you know, there's a lot of work
and involved. I have to Uber back and forth 3-4 times now, take the truck, get off the truck, go back the truck, go get the truck again to get ready. Other than that, it's great.
And it's hotter than hell.
And by the way, so then I go to pick it up like at 1-ish, 2-ish, whatever it was, because they said they'd hustle and do it. I go there, and I'm talking to this guy, and I don't know why, but he was a California conservative who left to go to Nevada. I said, shocking. I would love to also. Nice guy. Anyway, the end product is I got the bill. Now, I paid $175. I tipped $25 to make it $200. And now, to get the rack repaired was another $750. Now, doesn't sound like going cheap works, does it? So, it's my fault. I blame. And by the way, I got to pay for an RV spot that is nothing more than AstroTurf and cement. And it's not a good deal. So, we're going to show you some...
The moral of the story. Don't try to save money. I mean, if you get a good deal and you get something on sale, that's fine. But don't go with someone where you haven't seen and inspected their work.
The end product is, I was dead wrong. It's my fault. And by the way, Dee Dee said the same thing.
Over and over.
We're doing video.
Okay, here we go. Okay, we're stuck in sparks because our rack for our kayaks had a wee bit of a problem, and we were afraid we were going to lose them. So the truck is over getting welded.
There you go.
Your turn.
And they met the neighbor across from here. His name is Ron.
In this humongous two-story motorhome.
And he's from where? California.
Yeah,
country coach.
Southern California.
But the best thing about Ron, he loves country western music.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah, yeehaw.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places.